This happened on a 73 degree day in December. And I wonder, what effect does climate change have on this?
Certainly, we know that our climate is warming, but how that actually manifests itself into tornado outbreaks or tornado intensity or tornado location is difficult to determine. There's a lot of research going on. There are indications that potentially the tornado threat's moving farther east than it normally is, or that it might be occurring later in the year during these cool seasons, so these November, December, January, February, that might be more prolific for tornadoes than previously.
But the effect of climate change is unclear. Tornado formation is fleeting, complex, and not completely understood. 2020, for example, was one of the three hottest years on record, and it was an off year for tornadoes.
There's a lot we don't know about climate change and the weather.
But there's a lot of research being done trying to figure out what's happening with climate change and the weather. And really, I mean, there's no indication that any of these things are going to go away. So I think it's really what needs to be the focus is being prepared for these types of events.
In BC, this unusual snow comes after a year of intense weather, drought, a heat dome, catastrophic flooding, and this is just the beginning.
And I think this year was Mother Nature's way of telling us, hey, wake up to the fact that, hey, your Canadian weather is going to be different now.
I'm just going to return to climate change and just finish with a topic which I guess is on everyone's mind. So what side are you on? Are you a climate change believer, or is it all a great conspiracy and a load of nonsense? I'd like to suggest that this is really not a good way to think about the problem. Fundamentally, as I said at the beginning, climate change is a problem in theoretical physics. There for sure are uncertainties, and as a result of that, we have to express our results in probabilistic ways, which means we're talking about risk. So the fundamental question is not whether you believe or don't believe, it's whether you think these estimated risks of dangerous climate change are large enough that it's worth taking some sort of mitigating action, i.e. cutting our emissions of carbon dioxide. You could view the problem a little bit like in making a decision about whether to buy insurance against burglary in your house. You don't have to believe that your house will get burgled. It's just that if you think the risk is sufficiently high and you've got sufficiently many valuable properties, you want to take some sort of mitigating action, then maybe taking insurance is a good idea. On the other hand, if you don't think you own anything of great value or the insurance is outrageously expensive, then you don't take out insurance. But the issue is not about whether you believe or don't believe that your house will get burgled. It's a decision about balancing risks and costs. Now, in the case of insurance, I suppose it's a fairly sort of economic issue. With climate change, it's not quite as simple as that. There are moral issues and ethical issues and so on. But the science, all the science can do is go as far as saying, this is what the risks are, these are what the probabilities are. We move away from theoretical physics into the real world, and it's the world of politics and the world of ethics and morals and so on, and economics, in whether or not we actually do want to take that step towards mitigating the effects of climate change. So let me just sort of summarize that then in a few sentences. If you ask me, as a scientist, is the world warming? I will say undoubtedly it is. If you say, is it due to you know, human emissions of carbon dioxide, I will say almost certainly it is. If you say, will our continued emissions of carbon dioxide lead to dangerous levels of climate change? Well, if we can agree that dangerous means probably something in excess of 2 degrees of warming, I will say it seems quite likely that that will happen with any unmitigated emissions, continuing emissions. If you ask me, will cutting our emissions reduce the risk of these dangerous levels of climate change happening? I will say yes. That seems to be quite a robust aspect of the science. But if you ask me, should we therefore cut our emissions of greenhouse gases? I will say, well, that actually is not a question that science can dispassionately answer. It involves disciplines which physical scientists are not necessarily expert in. And so I will say to that question, answer the question, that is for you to decide. Thank you very much.
That was really good. Thank you. That was really good.